The countdown is on. A total eclipse of the sun on April 8th will draw in more than 31 million people across the United States. Prime locations will span from Texas to Maine and will hold suntastic viewing events. Joining us now to discuss this historic celestial experience is this gentleman here, NASA Artemis III project scientist Dr. Noah Petro. Doctor, thank you so much for being here today.
Well, thanks for having me on.
Our pleasure. So let's set the table. People are so excited about this. Here in Chicago, down in southern Illinois, we'll have totality. So in your opinion, your expert opinion, how do you do this the right way?
All right, so first thing about enjoying an eclipse is to have a plan. You said 31 million people are going to be coming to the path of totality. That means you can expect traffic. Bring your patience, bring some extra food, but have a plan. You also want to be prepared to participate in the eclipse safely. Anytime we talk about looking at the sun, even in the path of totality, you want to have either solar viewing glasses or have indirect viewing methods, except for the time of totality is being shown here. When it's safe to take off your glasses and look towards the sun, you want to be able to enjoy this safely. And so for anybody who's traveling into the path of totality, you want to have a plan. You want to know where you're going to end up. Now, during the eclipse, you can be anywhere. You can be in a park. You can be in a baseball stadium. You can be in any place that has a clear view of the sky. As long as it's not too cloudy, you can enjoy it. But again, having a plan and having the equipment is the first and most important thing to start with.
So I want to backtrack, make sure I understand you correctly. Right. In totality, you are okay not to use those glasses. That's
correct.
Okay.
Yeah, so the time when the moon is directly between the Earth and the sun, it is safe. Just that 3 minutes or so, it's okay. If you're at a larger event where you have an astronomer who might be able to guide people, it's when it's safe. But basically, if you have these solar viewing glasses on and you're looking up at the sun and you see the sun, and then the sun disappears, that's a great sign to take them off and start enjoying the spectacular show of totality.
Obviously, put them back on when that is in reverse effect. What about looking through a camera? Should you wear glasses when you look through a camera or a viewfinder?
Yeah, so absolutely. Anytime, if you have a telescope and it's pointed at the sun, you do not want to look through that unless you have a number of filters on there to block out the harmful energy of the sun from basically baking your eyes. Cameras are the same way. You know, sensitive optics, if you point them at the sun, it can do damage to your camera. So unless you have filters, unless you really have some expertise in how to do this, I would encourage people to just enjoy it without worrying about telescopes and cameras.
Talk about the partial eclipse that we will be observing here in Chicago, hopefully, if it's not too cloudy.
Exactly. So in Chicago, you have up to about 94%. So quite a bit of the sun will be blocked out, peaking at 2:07 p.m. local time. And so at that point, if you've got your solar viewing glasses on, you look up, you'll see the little sliver of a moon, of the sun poking out from behind the moon. You'll also notice the temperature drop. The graphic you were showing before is the change in insulation, how much solar energy is reaching the surface. You will notice it cooling off. Animals will go about their bedtime routines. It becomes this immersive experience, even at the 94% level, you'll notice all of these changes. It is this wonderfully immersive experience. In 2017, I enjoyed totality out in Oregon. And so it was this amazing experience that I was not prepared for, how much of the environment around me was changing. Shadows looked different. And again, the temperature drop, which you're seeing here, was something I really felt and was surprised by.
Yeah, that's amazing stuff. Enthusiasts and amateurs aside, what about the experts, the pros like you? What can you gather from all of this, the evidentiary side of things?
Yeah, so NASA will be launching some balloons up into the Earth's atmosphere. We'll be launching suborbital rockets. This is a wonderful experiment where effectively, along the path of totality, you're turning the sun off for a few minutes. How does the Earth's atmosphere respond? How do animals respond? There are a number of scientific hypotheses that we want to test during an eclipse. Because they're so few and far between, we use every total eclipse as an opportunity to learn more about our environment. We learn about the sun. We learn about the solar atmosphere by looking up with special telescopes towards the sun. And so even if it's a short period of time, every eclipse provides us with data. And 18 months from now, we'll go traipse around the world to go to the next eclipse and learn from that one. And so this becomes another data point in our never-ending endeavor to learn more about our place in the solar system.
Less than 30 seconds. I'm really curious, scientific aspect aside, eclipses have held such a value in mythology and ancient cultures. You seem like a guy who would be a well-rounded individual and would have something to say about that.
Yeah, you know, as I said before, eclipses are this immersive experience. You can imagine if you did not know an eclipse was coming and one happened, that might terrify you a little bit. And so eclipses have been used to for negative effects. I'm going to block the sun on this date if I know this is happening to terrify a population, but also as a celebration of our place in the solar system. So cultures throughout time have used eclipses, one, to mark time, but also for festives, celebrations, or negative effects. Now we know what causes them. We can predict them well into the future. And I think they should be celebrated as this moment where 31 million people are going to be banding together to enjoy a single event. It's not a rock concert. It's not a Cubs game. It's a total solar eclipse.
I appreciate your knowledge and certainly your energy today. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me on.
Our pleasure. You can check out more at nasa.gov. And please join WGN for coverage of the April 8th eclipse. Our own Tom Skilling's going to be back to enjoy the rare celestial event. Demetrius Ivory, Mike Jansen, also going to be in the path of totality. Different places, though, and we'll have additional reports from around our area. Our coverage begins just after the WGN Midday News on Monday at 1 p.m.